Hey everyone, it's Rock for Cash, the People's Champ, coming to you live from Cash Stadium. Welcome to this week's episode of Cash TV, where we will be reviewing what has happened in the FNFL in week 9. As we always do, before we start, we'll just fire up this week's song, always greatly appreciated and given to us by Team Mazza. This week's song is one that's definitely held very close to the heart of one FNFL coach, being Smooth Criminal, played ad nauseum on our ill-fated Murray River houseboat trip in 2012. It's Diamonds by Rihanna. So sit back and enjoy this as we take a ride through Cash TV and review what happened in week 9. Alrighty, so. First game of the round was Rock for Cash up against Team Mazza. As the Cash said in the previous episode, he always has trouble against Team Mazza, and there was no difference again this time, with Team Mazza getting up 113.64 against the Cash 109.52. So only 4.12 points separating these two teams. Great game was had. Team Mazza, Drew Brees got 31, the Vikings defense got 24, Greg Olsen got 13, Melvin Gordon 18. For the Cash, Kareem Hunt got 32.1. Step-in quarterback Ryan Fitzpatrick got 21. And a couple of 11s from Jimmy Graham and Zerline, the kicker from the Rams. You know, a close game. Cash was in front, Maz was in front. Cash was in front, Maz was in front. It went like that all game. Came down to Aaron Jones up against Jimmy Graham. Cash needed to outscore him by about 10. Outscored him by 6. So Maz got the chocolates. Well done, Team Mazza. That's moved them up to 6th spot on the ladder with 5 wins and 4 losses. The Cash still sit in 2nd spot, 6 wins and 3 losses. In the next game, never really close this game. Smooth Criminal, 128.16 against Shiva Kamini, 93.14. Smooth Criminal back up to 3rd spot, jumped up a couple of spots with 5 wins, 4 losses. Shiva Kamini still on the bottom, 2 wins, 7 losses, and they're on a 5-game losing streak, so they're going to really need to do something in the next 4 weeks before the end of the regular season if they're going to get out of Sacco relegation zone. But in this game, Smooth Criminal led beautifully by Kamara 29, the Dolphins defense 26, James White 22, Murray Cooper today's first game with Dallas 11.8, got a touchdown. For Shiva Kamini, the Bears defense amazing, 30 points. Deion Lewis today 18.2, Tommy Brady 13, Edelman 11, and Cody Parkey from the Bears with 11 as well. Like I said, Smooth Criminal really wasn't, you know, under too much duress in this game. Shiva's just got to find a way to win. Rumour is Le'Veon Bell is going to front Steelers Stadium sometime this week, but we'll just have to wait and see. I think it might be a little bit too late for the Shiva, but he's hanging on him all year. It'd be silly now to start trading him. But in the next game, geez, wasn't this a great game? Young Remix Killers travelled down to Kelpie Stadium. The Cash had written the Kelpies off. but in true Kelpie fashion, I know he doesn't want us to talk about him, but each week I have to. In this game, the Kelpies 91.62 defeated Young Remix Killers 91.1. It's only 0.52 points separated these two guys. From all accounts, the crowd loved this game. They're putting it down as a classic of FNFL history. It was just a great game. The Kelpies were led beautifully by Michael Thomas, 211 receiving yards. He scored 27.1. Travis Kelce, clearly the best tight end in the league from the Chiefs, 21.9. And Phil Rivers, 15. For the Young Remix Killers, Matty Ryan, love Matty Ryan, 26 points. Keenan Allen, 15.2, good return to form for him. The Titans, 13 today, and Antonio Brown, who always gets double figures, 10.2. But that's a great comeback by the Kelpies. They've moved themselves up to ninth spot now with 4 wins and 5 losses. Young Remix Killers down to 4th with 5 wins, 4 losses. Like I said, a great win by the Kelpie. Good to see him back on the winner's circle after a few losses in a row. I note that the Cash is still waiting for that interview with the Kelpie. It's disheartening that there has been no contact at all. I know he's on holidays at the moment, but a perfect time to make contact with the Cash and organise this interview. The Cash heads are screaming for Dave. They want the Kelpie on. So Dave, you know, do the right thing. Get on Cash TV. You know, you say you're a coach of the people. The Cash is the people's coach, but, you know, just make an effort, mate. We really would love to have you on Cash TV. In the next game, oh my God, the Browns again. 134.28 against future brother-in-law, the Moneymaker 7, 56.9. I mean, that's 78 points or nearabouts. And he didn't play a tight end again. He at the moment, can do no wrong. He's on 7 wins, 2 losses in first spot. Moneymakers, 3 wins, 6 losses in 11th spot. Again, his team, McCaffrey, 27. Connor, 22. Newton, 19. Gordon, 19. Cup, 14. The Chargers, 16. Elliott, 11. Oh, and Moneymakers, no one in double figures. This, obviously, the trade commission fiasco of the weekend is playing heavily on Moneymaker's mind. He's obviously taken his eye off the FNFL this week. It's a shame that this has happened. I can't prove it, but I think the Brown may have had something to do with all of this. I think he's played the Moneymaker into getting him upset, getting him to write his letter of resignation with the view of coming on the Trade Commission, and just like a virus, he would have just destroyed the Trade Commission. So Moneymaker, get your eye back in the game. Like I said, the Cash will have you on Cash TV in the next week or so to discuss mano y mano what is actually going on with this letter of resignation, which was rejected by the Trade Commission. Team Mazza spoke to him earlier on, getting diamonds from him. He has a lot of faith in the Trade Commission. He has a lot of faith in Moneymaker 7. Has zero faith in the Browns, as does the Cash. But we will look forward to hearing from you in a week or so. And like the Cash said, he never ever knocks back an interview, never ever stops anyone that wants to come on Cash TV. In the next game, little waiters were up against Mitch's Mongrels, hosting the Mongrels at Waiter Stadium. And Mongrels got up in this one, 113.2 to Little Waiters, 87.8. Mongrels are now 4-5 in 8th spot, with Little Waiters 5-4 in 7th spot. The Mongrels, Coleman from the Falcons got 27.6. The Mahomes train that The Rock just loves watching is on 24.8. Howard 16, Kittle 16. On the other side, for Little Waiters, Julio Jones finally got on the scorecard with a touchdown and 120 yards. He got 18. Hopkins got 16. Russell Wilson 15. And Smith from Atlanta, the running back, 12.4. I think it's Ito or Ito Smith, whatever another stupid name in the NFL. But this one was pretty much over from Thursday. I don't think the Little Waiters actually hit the front at all in this game. So another good win by you there, Min. Very underrated team you've got at the moment. If the Mahomes train keeps going, I think you might keep going too. So well done, champ. And Danielle, stumble, hopefully just a stumble. Get your team back on the track in week 10. In the last game, Archie's All-Stars were heading down, well, actually just across the road, really, from Werribee to Lara. They got 100.74 against Little River Giants, 92.2. So that brings Archie's All-Stars to 5 wins, 4 losses in 5th spot. And Little River Giants, 3 wins and 6 losses in 10th spot. A very close game. It was pretty much up and down even today. I think the scores were jumping back and forth a little bit. But in the end, Archie's All-Stars, just too good in the end. I see Adam Thielen didn't get his 9th week in a row of 100 plus yards, just disappointing. Just got the 22 yards, but you know, Goff, very underrated quarterback at the moment, 29.34, Howard 17, Murray and Cook both 10s. For Little River Giants, Roethlisberger 24.2, Cook 17, Ben Watson 12, and Gurley 13. Very quiet for Gurley this week, just the 68 yards and 1 rushing touchdown. So that's pretty much what's happened in week 9. For those of you that you either remember or could be bothered or actually give a flying, you know, what about, the quarterfinals of the FNFL Cup, the cup that has no name at this stage, were held this week. And in the quarterfinal matches, we saw Team Mazza, 113.84, defeat the Kelpies, 91.62. And in the other game, Archie's All-Stars, 100.74, defeated Moneymaker 7, 56.9. So basically, we've now got our final four teams for the semi-finals that will be held in week 13 of the FNFL. They are Rock for Cash, the Browns, Team Mazza, and Archie's All-Stars. The draw for this will be done just prior to the week 13 clash of the semi-finals, a computer-generated draw, and I'll tell you what the matchups will be in my week 13 preview. So with that, that's pretty much it for Cash TV tonight. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for making the time to listen to this old bastard ramble on for nearly 15 minutes about just basic shit. If you like this, subscribe to the channel. hit the little bell so that you get notified when Cash TV's been uploaded. Special thanks today to I'll keep her anonymous, but you know who you are, Sonia, who became Cash TV's 10th subscriber, taking us into double figures. Great milestone for the Cash to get into double figures on subscriptions. He's very, very excited about that. And again, thank you to that individual who remained nameless. Good on you, Sonia. About coming our 10th subscriber. As we go, we've got a little bit, still got Rihanna banging on in the background, the Illuminati, Luciferian pedo bitch that she is. But anyway, Cash will talk about that at another time. So with that, as the Cash always says, Cash is out.